Welcome to another episode of the 15 Minute a Day Cure. Today's topic, 4 ways to fight the holiday blues. Hi, I'm Margo Staten of BeGoodToYourselfByMargo.com and welcome to my channel. Here, I teach you simple strategies to improve your quality of life. If you're new here, wonderful to have you. I release new videos every Wednesday at 5 p.m. So the holidays are quickly approaching. And, you know, for some of us, holidays are, you know, a time where we get to, you know, get together with family and enjoy dinner and have events and party. And, you know, they're a symbol of joy and things that we look forward to. But for a lot of us, you know, having the holidays is a reflection of things we don't have. For a lot of us, we are unfortunately alone on the holidays. And while everybody's celebrating and while the Christmas trees go up and the lights are up in the neighborhood and, you know, turkeys are being cooked, you know, we're alone. And, you know, maybe we associate the holidays with something negative that has happened to us in our past. Maybe our mental health symptoms kind of get worse, or depression gets worse, or anxiety gets worse, you know. And if you're somebody who dreads having the holidays come around, you're not alone. You know, there's sort of this big picture expectation of what celebrating the holidays should look like, what Thanksgiving should look like, Christmas, New Year's, right? Big parties. But that's not necessarily what you need to do to enjoy the holidays, right? So these are 4 ways to fight the holiday blues. So number one is plan ahead. You know, so while I say, you know, right now, actually, as I'm recording this video, it's October. And yes, the holidays are fast approaching, right? We have Thanksgiving coming. Well, we have Halloween first. We have Thanksgiving coming up, and then we have Christmas and New Year's, you know, followed by, you know, Valentine's Day. And, you know, but technically speaking, holidays, I mean, they roll around every year at around the same time. So planning ahead and, you know, creating a holiday that's not necessarily the standard or the norm, and going into the holiday season with sort of a plan and a you know, focus of what you will be doing, as non-traditional as it might be, it kind of goes a long way to fight the holiday blues. So for example, for me, you know, I'm divorced, and around the holidays, me and my daughter's father obviously split the time. Now, I am a lover of Christmas. I love all things Christmas. I think I'm still a kid at heart. You know, even my colleagues at work kind of poke fun at me because I will have Christmas music on in my office, and it's July. So again, it's not about gifts. It's not about even getting together with family. I just love the lights. I love the brightness. I love the decorations. And I love, especially with Christmas, sort of that season of giving back and you know, doing good onto others, which we do throughout the year. But I don't know, there's just something about Christmas that kind of in itself uplifts me. And, you know, I'm somebody that obviously enjoys spending time with family and friends. But since I got divorced 5 years ago, holidays kind of just don't have the same appeal a little bit. And for example, I get my daughter Christmas Eve, and then her father gets her Christmas Day. Now, for somebody who loves Christmas as much as I do, there's nothing worse than being alone on Christmas Day every single year. It is quite depressing, and I am somebody that obviously preaches positive thoughts over negative ones, but, you know, again, solitude on a holiday like Christmas and sort of being at home and looking around your space and being alone, it sucks. And every year, as much as I look forward to Christmas and gift giving and decorating and all of that, I dread Christmas Day. For many years, I dreaded Christmas Day because I would be by myself. I would have to drop off my daughter and my dog, you know, to my in-laws and then just spend the day by myself. Like, it was horrible. So a couple of years ago, I decided, you know what? I'm going to do things and I'm going to plan ahead and create activities for myself that are fun for me. And also, to be quite honest, distract me from sort of how I feel and sort of from having holiday blues. So now every single year I plan DIY projects. Oftentimes they're Christmas related. I will build things, I will kind of consume myself with a hobby, and I do love DIY just in general. I will consume myself with a hobby. I also spend a lot of time in sort of the weeks leading up to Christmas, donating, and if I can and if I have the time, working at a soup kitchen or packaging boxes or providing services and volunteering in the community. So, sort of the holidays have taken on a very different perspective for me. Whereas before, every time I knew Christmas was around the corner, I would get this uncomfortable feeling in the pit of my stomach because I knew come Christmas Day, and Thanksgiving as well, I would feel very, very down. And it was horrific, and I didn't want to feel that way anymore. And there was nothing I could change about the situation, right? When you're divorced, you split holidays and you split days and you have your schedule. So it's not like I could say, no, you know what? I'm keeping her. So again, the reality was I couldn't change what's happening, but I could change my approach by planning ahead and filling my days and my weeks with things that are positive and doing good onto others and being grateful for what I have, because at the end of the day, it's just a day, right? So again, mentally preparing yourself and just kind of planning ahead for the holidays can substantially decrease the holiday blues. Number two, create unconventional new traditions. And that is kind of what I'm talking about. So again, holiday blues can be as a result of maybe your family lives very, very far away and you can't be with them. Come up with non-conventional traditions. Make the holidays something unique, right? So who cares how everyone else is celebrating them? And look, guys, it's still sad to not be with the ones that we love, and it's still sad to be alone, and it's still sad because maybe we're plagued with negative thoughts, but it's also fun to come up with, treat it as a project. It's fun to come up with new traditions to spend the holidays. And my recommendation is have them be silly and have them be fun. Maybe around the holidays you like have a dance-a-thon, or you do karaoke, like even if it's by yourself, or like I hang out with my dog, and talk to her on Christmas Day and Thanksgiving Day. But do stuff that's fun, like start a project. Maybe I actually have a friend who invites her neighbors, right, for dinner, right? Folks that live in her building. So again, yeah, it's not family. That is not the traditional way of spending the holidays, but it's your way. And who's to say how you should spend the holidays and what it should look like? As long as you're happy, right? Get wild, get creative, and create unconventional ways and celebrate it in your own way. Because guess what? There are a lot of people who are in the same position as you are, and probably a lot of your neighbors or acquaintances and friends. And maybe tis the era of technology. Maybe you have a Zoom celebration. But again, come up with creative and fun, new, unconventional, and sort of create your own traditions for what the holidays look like. You do not have to be consumed by the blues. You do not have to be consumed by the negativity, because you unfortunately can't have Christmas or Thanksgiving look the way that it's expected to look, and that's okay. Number three, treat yourself and others. A big way to fight the holiday blues is to give back. I am a firm believer in, playing Santa Claus. I think it's an amazing thing to even discreetly give out gifts or volunteer your time, whether it's at a soup kitchen or at a shelter or at a children's hospital or, again, whatever. There are tons of things in the community that you can sign up for ahead of time where you can give your time and your efforts to folks that need it. And that, believe me, that's not gonna fuel the blues. It's going to uplift you. But this is where number one comes in, right? Planning ahead, because just so you know, a lot of these volunteer opportunities, you start signing up for them in September and October. By the time December rolls around, a lot of these things are already filled up. And but again, there's always something you can do, something kind. You can stop by a local church or any type of other organization in the neighborhood and see how you can help. It could be things like even delivering meals, right, around the holidays. But if you do something good, and again, you plan ahead and you do something good for somebody else, for multiple people, it makes you feel good and you naturally eliminate the holiday blues. And finally, number four, Avoid financial stressors. So, you know, holiday blues again typically are because you're alone or because you can't be with family or because, you know, things have changed in your life. And maybe this year will be the first year that your holidays don't look like they did before. So it's extra stressful. But another huge contributor for holiday blues are financial stressors. We tend to have a lot of expenses. We also tend to not budget and overspend around the holidays. And I know that that comes out of the goodness of your hearts, and we want to give the best gifts to our friends and our families and our children, especially, right? But at the same time, if it's going to be a huge financial burden to you, and if once the holidays roll around and people are opening up their gifts or whatnot, and all you can think about the debt that you put yourself into, again, that is something that's avoidable. My recommendation is create a very simple budget. You know, I always create a list of who I need to give gifts to, and sort of some of my volunteer work and whatnot. And, you know, think about how much money you have and how much money you're able to dedicate for every single purchase, whether it's for each person. I mean, I think it's a good practice to write down everybody you need to give a gift to, because also, you know, it's a nice way to sort of structure kind of the holiday season for yourself. You know, you don't have to last minute rush like, oh my goodness, I forgot my boss, you know, or whatnot. But it's really the way I do it is I write down every single person, and next to their name, I kind of budget out how much I'm willing or how much I'm able to spend. And then at the end, obviously, I have my full budget, and I make sure that I stick within the budget by constantly like writing down, this is what I spent, this is how much it adds up to. Again, that alleviates a lot of that financial stressor, so you're not going into the new year's in debt, and you're not focused around the holiday time thinking about, oh my goodness, how much money you spend, right? Because again, that in itself is very stressful. So those are my four ways to fight the holiday blues. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please hit the subscribe button and hit the like button if you enjoyed my content. And always remember to be good to yourselves.